Hey, welcome back, guys. Vince Spampinato here, and today we're going to talk about how to tell stories in our final expense telesales process. How do we create these stories, and how do we implement them into our final expense telesales process? So let's get right into it. You see, guys, storytelling is one of the best tools that we have when selling over the phone, right? The customer can't see us, they can't touch us, they can't feel us, they only can hear us, they can only feel our body language by the way we use our tonality and our hands and the way we speak. We have to be able to tell stories, effective stories that create emotion in our customers. And by doing so, our prospect is going to be more likely to pay attention and retain the information. Now, sales stories work best when they're tailored to each individual prospect, right? While it may be easy to have one or two canned stories that we tell in every sales process, it's simply not the most effective way at targeting the prospect's individual needs. So we have to come up with customized stories that are going to basically be directed at their hot button issues or their exact situations. Fortunately for you, we're creating this training today, and I am going to go over a simple way for you to design, or I should say a simple format that's going to make it easy for you to design and come up with your own customized stories. All it's going to take from you is just a little bit of thought and some time and some old elbow grease writing it all out. So let's go ahead and jump right into this and get into the meat and potatoes of how you can create a customized sales story for all of the different situations that you run into on the daily when selling final expense insurance over the telephone. You ready? All right, let's go. Now, to tell effective sales stories, you need to get to know your customer, right? I mean, you gotta know your customer. After all, you're not gonna be able to tell any stories to your customer if you don't know anything about them, right? You're not going to be able to help them, right? You're not going to be able to tell a story. So I always tell you guys this, and I'm going to tell you again, you first and foremost have to do a freaking effective warm-up, right? You can't do effective storytelling if you don't know about your customer and you don't have their guard down and you haven't found out any facts about your customer. You haven't learned about their needs. You haven't found out anything about whether or not they're married, if they're widowed, if they have children, or, you know, you can't get into a story with them if you don't know anything about them. And too many of you, not all of you, but too many of you are skipping the fact find and the warm up. And so therefore, you can't even tell a good story or stories to your customer. So, do we got that clear? You gotta do a warm-up. You gotta do a great fact find. And if you don't know how to do that, we gotta learn. We gotta practice. You gotta get into the televersity, and you gotta go and keep practicing that in order to get to the storytelling part of the deal, okay? Now, the more you know about your prospect, the better your stories will be, because you can use what you know to make the story resonate and hit their hot button issues, right? So let's talk about a few examples that we all run into every single day when you sell final expense insurance over the phone. Now, I'm gonna give you 7 examples of 7 different stories that you can write yourself. I'm not gonna write the stories for you because I don't know your stories, okay? But I'm gonna give you 7 different stories or ideas or topics that you can write customized stories around yourself, or you can even tell stories if you don't have a story in third person maybe about a family member or a friend or a past customer or prospect. You can always find a way to write a story around these seven topics. Now, the first two, I'm going to go into a little bit more detail. The last five, I'm just going to give you the topic, and then I'm going to ask you to write the stories out yourself. So here we go. Number one story is you're talking to a person like a widow who just lost their husband 2 years ago, right? It doesn't have to be a woman. It could be a man. It could be anybody, right? You're talking to somebody who lost somebody and they didn't have insurance, right? They didn't have insurance in place. How many of us know somebody who's passed away who didn't have insurance? Now, probably most of you are raising your hands. Now, if you don't know somebody personally, you certainly know people that you've talked to on the phone, or you may have a friend. And if you don't, then go and start asking people what the story is so you can write it out, okay? So that's number one topic. So what should you be showcasing in this type of a story, right? So you learn about this about your customer, and now you're going to tell a story about something that happened to you. What should you showcase here? What do we want in the story? Okay. So you should have in your story about what happened to that family member. Okay. What happened to them at that time? You should find out why that person didn't have insurance when they passed away and incorporate that into your story. Okay. Find out the how, the what, the why, and incorporate that into your story and create emotion in the story, right? That needs to be in the story. And then what you want to do is you want to create an emotional part of the story by going into detail about how it affected that person, okay? Or how it affected their family, okay? And then to conclude the story, you want to assume the sale around it. You want to make an assumption of the sale. You want to say something to the effect of, you know, Mary, and that's why I am so glad that we're talking today, because I know that you don't want the same thing to happen to your daughter, right? Okay, good. Well, we are going to make sure that we get this coverage in place for you today, as long as we can get you qualified for the coverage, okay? Now, what you've done is you've told the story, you've gotten the customer emotional, and then you've assumed the sale around it, and you've gotten them to agree. That is the ultimate way to get the customer emotional and get them going with the process, get them saying yes, getting them into that buying state of mind. Okay, so that's the first option. You have a story about how somebody died and didn't have coverage in place, right? The second story that you want to make sure you have written out is when you're talking to a person who lost their insurance because they retired and they lost it in their retirement, right? How often do you run into that type of situation? You should have a story about how that happened to you, your family, your father, your mother, somebody that's close to you, okay? You want to talk about how that affected them when that happened, right? You want to talk about how more and more companies are taking away these benefits, how they're increasing the cost on them. You want to then explain how you or your family member went about fixing that situation in detail so that they never had to rely on a job or a company or a government for their final expense needs, right? And then once you've done that story, you want to conclude your story by assuming the sale on them. So you would say something to them like, you know, Tony, that's why I am so glad that you and I are talking today, because I know you don't want this ever happen to you, right? Right. Okay, good, good. And we're going to make sure that if we can get you approved today, we're going to make sure we get you some coverage in place today, okay? Again, you're getting them emotional. You're getting them to visualize themselves without insurance, and then you're assuming the sale around your story, and you're getting them to agree. You smelling what I'm cooking here, right? Are you getting it? Good. So let's talk briefly about five more topics that you can write stories for in your final expense telesales presentation. You want to have a story for illnesses like diabetes, cancer, COPD, and how it can affect their ability to get good insurance coverage, right? You want to be able to tell a story about how somebody you know died of diabetes or cancer, like my mother passed away from cancer. Okay, I can tell that story. Okay, you want to have number two. Okay, really, this is the fourth one because I've already gone over the first three. This is number four. You want to have a feel-good story about what happens when somebody dies with coverage, right? And then again, assume the sale around it, okay? Number five, you want to have a story around why you do what you do, why you enjoy your profession, why you're passionate about helping people, and share that story with them so that they can feel your passion and your emotion. They can get to like you, right? Have a story around that. So if the customer tells you what they did for a living, boom, now you can tell them a story around why you do what you do for a living, okay? Have a story around your family, your children. Paint a picture about your kids, your family, your marriage, okay? I'm jumping ahead here. Number four is have a story about your children. Okay, I should say number six is have a story around your children. Number seven, have a story around your marriage, your family. Okay, you want to have these stories and they need to be written out. So I want you to think about all of the situations that you encounter on a daily basis in your fact find, in your warm up, in the needs analysis. And I want you to write out some custom stories that you can implement to each type of situation that you're encountering, okay? So let's talk about some of the rules when writing your stories out. I'm going to give you some pointers here when writing your stories out. The first one is the more specific your story is, the more detailed your story is, the more impact it will have on your customer, on your prospect, on your listener, okay? It's gonna have more impact. So you don't wanna improvise. Do not improvise. Don't just try to make up sales stories on the fly. Very, very few people that I know can improvise a convincing story, okay? Now, you probably are going, oh, that's me, I'm good at that. Listen, you're not as good as you think you are. Write it out, please. Don't be so prideful and egotistical that you can't do this. Take the time. If you want to be a pro, take the time. Draft out your story. Write it out and then read it aloud from a script. This will help you identify where your story lacks or lags or skips something very important. You want to write it out. Better still, have your production mentor or a sales manager or myself act as your audience, act as your customer. Let's role play it together for your first few stories, okay? Once you've gotten the hang of writing out these stories, you're going to be a good judge for yourself. It becomes really easy. You can prepare for these actual story writing by composing a list of the most important components to you. Okay, jot down the facts, okay? Jot down what it is that you want to get accomplished. Jot these things down. Kind of have a brainstorming session with yourself, okay? Write down all the benefits that best apply to each story. What's going to get the customer emotional? What's going to get them engaged? What's going to get them thinking, okay? And then these are the elements that are the basic storyline. You want this to be implemented in all of your stories, the structure for your story. Now, the last thing that I want to leave you with is when writing these stories, the most important thing to drive emotion is to use adjectives and action words, like verbs, right? So when you're telling a story about a coffin or about somebody who's passed away or a situation, you want to use adjectives around time, touch, emotion, color, size, taste, personality, right? You want to have these words that describe or identify or further define the nouns and the pronouns that you're using in your story. These are the words that create the pictures in your prospect's mind. Okay? So you want to use words, if I were going to use words that describe touch, I would use words like fluffy or sharp or freezing or silky smooth or it was so bumpy or fuzzy or slimy, right? When you hear these words, it paints a picture in your mind, right? Here's a few words or adjectives that describe emotion, okay? Words like abrasive or embarrassed or grumpy or abrupt or energetic or he was so kind or I was so afraid. I was so scared. I was afraid or I was enraged or I was just so lazy that I didn't even get the coverage in place or, you know, I was agreeable with the first insurance agent that presented to me, but I just didn't buy from him because I procrastinated. Or I am so enthusiastic. Like these are words that describe emotion and that paint a picture in the customer's mind. The more of these words that you can use in your stories, the more imagery you're going to create in their mind. This is helpful in getting in keeping our customers and prospects' interest and engagement. So, I'm almost out of breath. Okay? I'm almost out of breath. So, I'm going to sum this up for you. The bottom line is this, folks. The bottom line is this. You need to get good at telling stories. You need to write them out. You need to practice them. Your sales stories shouldn't take more than a few minutes to write out. If they're taking that long for you to write out, you're overthinking it, okay? Think of just the 7 things that I went through, okay? And then write out a story for each one of them. And then when you encounter those situations, customize the story to your customer's needs, okay? By doing so, you're going to engage more customers. You're going to have better conversations and you're going to help more people. Okay? If the people start to engage with you in the story, stop talking and allow them to start talking. Allow them to get engaged. Allow them to start talking and get emotional with you. And if they do, that's a good sign that your stories are working and you're on the right track. Now, go out there, write some stories, and make it happen, folks. See you later.